Greetings, this is James Grigsby from Rotary Totem, and I'm really pleased to announce the 35th anniversary of Shapuno Zoo by Motor Totemist Guild. Now, this album was originally released in 1988 on the No Man's Land label out of West Germany. It was still a divided nation at that point. Now, what I've done this year is I've remastered the analog tracks for the digital domain, and this will be the first release of this album in its entirety in the digital format. Now, originally, this record was recorded on 2-inch tape, 30 IPS, 16 track, which is a great format. You gotta love that tape. However, there's one sort of tricky part about 16 track is you always want more tracks. So if you look at the track sheets, you'll see a lot of these tracks we doubled up on. So there may be more than one instrument on a track, which means the mix is tricky. So it was one of these scenes where you've got four people huddled around the mixing board doing a live analog mix. So this is all old school analog all the way. The group, in 1987, we went into the studio. We were working at Telstar Studios in Burbank, and the engineer was Curt Wilson. He's also the singer of 5UUs. This is the recommendation that was made to me by Dave KERMAN, whom I met when we worked on this record, the Coma compilation album. His band 5UUs had a track on this, and from that point on we became friends and started working together on some musical ideas. He asked me to write some arrangements for the album he was working on, Elements. And at that point I asked him to help me work on Shapuno Zoo, and by the end of the record he had joined the band. We had grown over the past couple of years from a trio with myself and Lynn JOHNSTON on woodwinds, Becky HENINGER on cello. Next we added Emily Hay on vocals, flute, and piccolo. She became the fourth member. Then I added Eric Strauss on percussion, and he had been part of the group for the first album, which was a studio-only album. Shapuno Zoo would be our third album. He joined the group as a performing member at that point. So now we're up to a quintet. With the addition of KERMAN, it became a sextet, making it really hard for everyone to fit into my Peugeot 409. So it made gigging a little more tricky, but we continued performing. And in fact, the works on this album are all performed live in the studio, with overdubs, of course, but the basic tracks are all live. Now, for the 35th anniversary edition, it's digital only, but we're also including a PDF that'll have the album art, lyrics, credits, and some photos of the group that have not been published before. So that's a kind of an extra added bonus. So this will all be released on Bandcamp only. So I'll put the links, and I hope you enjoy the 35th anniversary of Shapuno Zoo.